Welcome back, everyone. Last episode, we created the loom. We created this bitch, and I didn't see it, but it was asking us to add traits to it. Which I think I added all the traits, but you can just basically like look down on here and see. Oh, there's better ones. I didn't see that. Well, sucks to suck. Anyway. So, we just need to speak to Deke about it.
I use the enchanted loom, Deke.
Wonderful.
Will I be able to weave even more powerful magic into my clothing with the loom?
You will, by rescuing even more powerful beasts. For now, however, Deke suggests you explore the vivarium and get to know the beasts you've already rescued.
Okay.
Thank you for your help, Deke.
Okay. So, I'm gonna collect all these, because I think, yeah. There we go, and not this way, it's the other way. Nope, not that way. And then after grabbing these, we'll go do our other stuff. I really love this place. This place is looking out nicely. I mean, coming out nicely. Anyway. I did have something. This. Maybe not. I thought I grabbed something. Oh, here it is. Where am I gonna put this?
Deke hasn't seen this many plants here before.
There. That's cool. Have we gotten anything else? I don't think so. I mean, apart from a couple of things. Excuse me. No. Nope. And no. Okay. So now, we need to go on quests. Do this one. What is this one? We can do that one later. Or I can do that in between episodes. And then... whoa. And that's why I wanted to explore a lot more. Damn, even our... actually. Nice. I was about to say, even our closest to flu powder is not... or flu, whatever the fuck. It's not good enough. Alrighty, on the broom again, can't wait to get on the broom again. I don't like the
castle, must have been quite stately in its time.
Oh, wait. What's with the butterfly? It's moving. Is that above me? Oh, it's these. Nice. I didn't know that was a thing, but sure. Thank you, butterflies. Oh. I guess I gotta go around this thing. Oh wait, dark wizards. Stop. Dark wizards. Oh, they're right underneath me. I was about to ask, like, where are they? And... what? Where are they? Are they like underneath this place? No, that's not what I want. Yeah, there's like a cave. There we go. Let's just fight these fuckers for now. Oh, they're not. You thought how? Wait! Oh god! Ow! You thought? Why? Ready? Okay. There we go. Ay! Oh my god, I'm getting a bang. Heal, 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 heal! I don't know why she wasn't healing. I was pressing G. Okay. Maybe we'll do that later. I should have used... Well, now we're here. I'm gonna use the chomping, whatever the fuck. Go for it. Okay. Got your ass. Got your ass. Got your ass. There we go. I'm gonna use this on... I wanted to do it. Use it on one of them. There we go. You thought? What am I doing? Okay, so just... Leave me the fuck alone, bro! Holy shit, this dog is actually super fucking stupid. Whee! Okay, where's this dumbass dog? Oh, this motherfucker's... Ayya, fucking bastard. There. Got his ass. Get his ass. Get his ass. Get his ass. There. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. That was clutch. Oh, yeah. I keep forgetting not to do that. Why? Fucking. Why? There. Okay, everything happened except what I wanted. Holy crap. Oh, that was kind of annoying. But we got through. What the fuck does this do? Oh, I was about to say, did I do that for nothing? Give me. Nice. Anything else? There is something over there. There's also something right there too. I didn't press that, but sure. Actually, I do think. There we go. And there we go. Is this just the way out? I'm guessing it is. Yep, it is. Okay. There's also Merlin's trial here. We'll do that later. We gotta go around this big ass fucking mountain. Okay. Oh, we gotta go around. Like, I thought it was gonna be like a little bit around. Here we go. Here we go. Cool. Whoa! There should be flu powder somewhere here.
I should investigate.
I don't know if there is. I just feel like there should. Yeah, there is.
Oh, how I love a good puzzle.
And there we go.
Well, enjoy your time in Irondale.
Irondale. Huh. That's a nice place. Oh, goblins.
Enjoy suffering, do you?
No. Leave me alone, kiddos. They're not kiddos, they're goblins. Is that me to say to one a gob? Am I really not allowed to go over there? I don't think I am. Unless it... Let me see. Excuse me. Meow. There we go. Oh, this is another castle. Is there flu powder anywhere here? There is, to my left. Is it? Oh no, it's right in front of me. There we go.
Now you should be able to travel to and from
Felton. Alrighty. Nice. Hello.
You made it.
Yeah, I did.
Enjoying the view?
Keeping an eye on things. Feldcroft isn't what it used to be. No one has felt safe here since Ranrock's loyalists took a peculiar interest in that castle over there.
Damn.
Rookwood Castle. My uncle Solomon is a former Aura and refuses to look into it. Even after Anne was cursed by one of them. Possibly with a wand, no less.
I heard a goblin refer to wizard kind as wand carriers. Are goblins forbidden from carrying wands?
Yeah.
Precisely. That's why I'm on the hunt for answers. If I'm to cure her, I need to understand what happened to her. Anne was always the most mischievous of the three of us. Which is saying something, knowing me and Ominous.
Damn.
I'm hoping a surprise visit from me and a new friend from Hogwarts will help lift her spirits. Bring back the Anne I used to know. Come on.
Yeah.
I'll take you to my uncle's.
I mean, what if she just has depression?
This way.
Like, not to throw shade, but, you know. Could be a possibility.
Feldcroft used to be a lot livelier.
Back in these days, mental health was not the biggest thing.
Everyone stays out of sight. Here we are. My sister should be just inside.
You're just gonna... Okay.
Aha! Sebastian, where did you...
Aww.
Is that what I think it is?
We've been over this, boy. Hey. Shrivel figs cannot reverse a curse. Nothing can.
What curse does she
the
have?
The sooner you accept that reality, the better.
But we haven't tried everything.
There is no cure.
To what curse?
When will you accept that?
Never. I can never accept it.
Now look what you've done.
I'm sorry.
Leave.
Really? Nobody can help her? Well,
I'm sorry you had to see that. If you don't mind, I just need a moment alone.
Poor Sebastian. Not the visit he'd hoped for.
I'm sorry about earlier. Those bouts of pain are difficult to bear.
Hogwarts isn't the same without you. Well, Sharp is still as foul, but you know what I mean. Hope you're feeling better, Sebastian. Okay.
Revelio.
Anything else I can do? Sebastian, this is my potion kit, not yours. Leave my things be, Han. Damn.
Are you all right, Anne? I didn't mean to intrude.
You didn't, truly. And I'm all right. The pain from this curse comes in bouts, and often suddenly. It's not anyone's fault. It's nice to meet you, by the way. You must be the new fifth year Sebastian told me about.
I am.
Sebastian and I met during a rather lively duel in defense against the dark arts.
Oh, dear Professor Hecate. She's a powerful witch. And she knows how to keep students like my brother and me in line. I do miss Hogwarts. But I wouldn't mind being in Feldcroft, really, if it wasn't so dreary now. Between the goblins at the castle and my uncle fighting with Sebastian whenever he's home. It's not the cozy retreat it once was.
Sebastian mentioned something about your uncle being an ex-Aura, but refusing to go after Ranrock's loyalists. I must say,
pussy.
I wasn't prepared for him to be as angry as he was.
Yeah.
Uncle Solomon is frustrated by what happened to me, and by Sebastian for thinking he can fix it. They both mean well, I know they do, but my uncle is right. This curse cannot be undone. I can feel it. Sebastian cannot take away my pain. Perhaps you can help him to understand that.
I mean, I don't know. This is truly a family matter that I just burst into, and I don't even know why they're asking me to do all this. Sebastian has a right to try. I don't know. Because it's like, someone had an illness that hurt them a lot. And their family member were trying to get rid of that, you know, pain. Should they be stopped? I mean, I guess it's depending on the person that's fucking dealing with the pain. But at the same time, if like you're in pain and like they call an ambulance on you, the ambulance is gonna take your ass. You know what I mean? Fuck. I can try. Fuck. Especially because they take away my pain, perhaps you can help him understand that. I kind of don't want him to give up either. There's no way that you can't take away a curse. I don't know. He's made up his mind.
I'm afraid it's really up to Sebastian. And his mind seems to be made up.
I can only hope he realizes the futility of his search for a cure soon. I'm getting tired. I should probably rest. Thank you for stopping by.
I'm sorry, girl.
I wish you well.
Same. Fuck, bro. Ah, flashbang.
That boy will fray my last nerve.
Excuse me, Mr. Sallow.
Oh, yes. Sebastian's friend. I apologize on behalf of my nephew.
You're good.
Doesn't know when to stop. I was about to check on Anne. Did I see you come from the house? How is she?
She's all right. She said she was going to rest.
Nothing can be done for her.
It's not my thing to say.
I'm so sorry.
If he's given up, I can't, you know. It's the same thing with Sebastian.
Mungo's to no avail.
We have. My nephew thinks he knows better than the healers.
Perhaps the healers don't know everything, sir. Sebastian is single-mindedly focused on finding a way to help his sister.
Yeah, I mean, if there's ancient magic that nobody knew about.
Your faith in Sebastian is misplaced. Some sort of dark magic cursed Anne. And the goblins aren't likely to explain themselves anytime soon. Giving her hope is cruel. The only thing to do now is keep Anne comfortable.
Well, that's really fucked up.
The loyalist's way.
I understand what you're saying, sir.
Good. I know what's best for Anne and Sebastian. They are my stubborn brother's children.
Damn.
Especially Sebastian. If you really want to be of help, you'll make sure Sebastian does what he should do. Not what he wants to do. He's no idea the harm he could do if he doesn't stop.
I mean,
I hope you remember what I've said. Good day.
Good day.
Seems faring.
I mean,
why will he not listen to me? She's my sister.
How are you doing, Sebastian?
You got a first-hand glance of what I'm dealing with. I apologize for my uncle.
He was out of line. He's trying to do what's right. I don't know if that's right. Fuck, dude, this is actually really hard. I don't know if my options actually change the game. or the outcome of this quest. But honestly, my personal view, I think he's out of line. I don't think he's doing the right by giving up and saying, like, you know, you can't fix it. So,
I'll admit, I wasn't expecting him to be so angry.
He's always angry. He's been angry since my parents died.
Damn.
After Anne was hurt, he only grew worse. It's as though he blames me somehow, always calling me my father's son, as if that's an insult. I'm the one trying to help her. He's simply given up.
Yeah.
Both Anne and your uncle seem genuinely convinced that nothing more can be done for her.
I refuse to believe that. Anne's pain is more than physical. It has changed her entirely. I miss my sister. And I'm going to get her back. Come with me. I need to show you where it happened.
Okay.
Ranrock's loyalists are capable of so much more than people realize.
Was it here?
They should not be underestimated.
Yeah, I mean...
All the debris you'll see is from whatever's going on. Ooh, at that abandoned estate. They've been...
Sorry. Just wanted to fuck with one of the dummies. So... Yeah, it's not great to give up, but...
Up there, on that plateau, is where they cursed Anne. This way.
Why were you guys up here? Anyway. It's just... I don't know. It's too much for me to take right now. Oh shit. There we go. That is that. Slow a loyalist assassin. Does that work? I think I might need to use the rest of momentum. There. Took me a little bit.
One less human to worry about.
That didn't work. Woo! How do I stop them? Okay. I don't know how I did that.
Stop! I'm afraid of heights!
Whee! Ow! You thought how? Slam a leaping loyalist to come there to the ground. Okay. So I guess she's that didn't work. God damn. Okay. Where's this dude? Oh, dude. Whoa!
You've made your last mistake.
Have I? What's going on? Oh, I was about to say that. Did I get stuck in this? Holy shit. You thought, huh? Okay, where's that other dude? Damn, she went far. Here, Kashi-san. I can't see. Cool. Thank you. I love throwing these fucking boulders at them. Oh, there you go. Okay. There we go. God damn, bro.
I confess, that was a bit more than I bargained for. I tried to warn you.
Jeez. Well, I mean...
Rebellia.
Is there anything I can still hear? No. Okay. So this is where they cursed her? Why were you guys up here?
Those loyalists deserved what they got.
Couldn't agree more. This is where it happened. We smelt smoke in the middle of the night. When we looked outside, flames were shooting from the estate.
I guess it was probably summer for them.
And rushed out, racing towards the fire, worried someone would be hurt. She came face to face with a horde of goblins, frantically trying to stamp out the flames. Suddenly, an icy voice drifted out from somewhere in the smoke. Children should be seen and not heard. A blinding blast followed. They didn't even give her a chance to run.
Damn. They were trying to hide something. They're killing for no reason. They're probably trying to hide something.
Seems an awfully violent response to a child wandering by. What were they trying to hide?
My thoughts exactly. It may be grasping at Billywigs, but I keep thinking that there might be something here that could lead me to whoever cursed Anne.
Just use Revelium.
The only way to learn what type of magic harmed her, which could help me find a cure.
Perhaps you're right. The loyalists are everywhere, but they do seem to be spending a lot of time here, and it's likely they're hiding.
Girl, we just got here.
And
how do we know that?
At Rookwood Castle. Shall we have a look around?
Yeah, sure.
Revelio.
They seem to have set up camp here for a specific reason.
Whose home was this?
Been abandoned long since I've lived here. Rumor was a Hogwarts professor lived here once, centuries ago. But that's all I ever heard.
Oh, then it says.
Always armed and ready
or
for
hers.
A fight, Ranrock's loyalists.
Maybe she has something to do with it? So this statue is facing this way, and that statue is facing that way. Does that mean... That's a giant... I was about to say, it's a giant-ass bird. So it might be something...
I've heard that goblin dig sites like these are popping up everywhere.
It's a wonder the Ministry isn't doing more.
Honestly?
It might be worth taking a closer look at the house itself.
So this one's facing this way. So that one's facing that way, this one's facing this way. Yoink. Sorry, Sebastian. I'm looting some shit. So it's probably one of the professors that we saw, or
this
one of the girls.
Well looks familiar.
It's a girl. Excuse me.
Revelio.
Yep, it's a girl.
Sebastian, I've seen this before. The house, the well, the view.
What do you mean? When?
Give me a moment. I'll explain in a second.
Yep. So this was her house.
Sebastian, over here. Do you think this was damaged by the fire the night that Anne was cursed?
Could be. But it looks to me as though this was intentional.
Yeah. Maybe they were trying to scare the portrait into talking.
Sebastian, this house did belong to a Hogwarts professor hundreds of years ago.
Who? What do you...
I found a pensive that day in the restricted section with a memory that showed this house. There was a little girl and a drought. The keepers have shown me other memories as well. The girl became a Hogwarts professor.
I thought she was going to say a whore.
Her name was...
I'm sorry.
She was one of the keepers.
The keepers? Like in Quidditch? And you found a pensive in the library? I'm not following you.
I realize it's a lot to take in. I'm not even sure I understand it all yet. And no, not like Quidditch. They call themselves keepers because they're protecting some type of knowledge.
It all has
to do with the vault at Gringotts.
Let me see if I've got this straight. You have Ranrock and Rookwood after you because of something you found at Gringotts where you ended up via a portkey. You can see traces of an ancient magic that you think Ranrock is trying to harness. And now you've been witnessing memories left by keepers. Oh, and this house belonged to a Hogwarts professor who was one of these non-Quidditch keepers hundreds of years ago. If I didn't know you, I think you were pulling my leg.
It is all a bit much, isn't it? When you put it like that. The point is, we both have good reason to search this house.
Yep.
You for answers about what happened to Anne, and me for answers about the keepers.
Well, gang, seems like
Look
we have a mystery
this.
In our hand.
Someone piled this here for a reason. Is it blocking something?
Only one way to find out.
We couldn't get through that on over here anyway.
Why bother blocking a stairwell?
There might be something here worth a closer look.
Just need to make sure.
They've left all of this simply strewn about. Tells me they're after something bigger.
Okay, well, I'm probably gonna need this. And maybe this?
Lumos.
It is my second week in the camp. More arrive each day. The Muggle doctors have even some our own. Even some of our own healers are doing all that they can for them. The grief is palpable. The ones who have survived the plague are forever damaged by their loss. A fever may pass, the skin may mend and scar, but the devastating sorrow remains. I saw a man much like my father who had lost a child. I couldn't bear it. I long to give him some shred of relief. I'm beginning to think that the others are wrong. I have the power to help these souls. Seems as arbitrary not to help them as it would be rid of them of their own torment.
Journal entry of Isidore's. I should hold on to this.
I traveled here to learn, but I long to help. Sorry. My eternal struggle is overwhelming. It's as though the magic wants to heal, and I am the one preventing it from doing so. Should I lose hope? Will I forever regret not having done more? I cannot look into their eyes knowing that I could lessen the burden of heartache. I saw the man leaving camp today, the one who so reminded me of my father. Surely it wouldn't hurt to help him. I could further my research, of course, but that would be fortuitous consequences of doing something good with disability.
Seems these journal entries are from Isidore's travels. Lumos.
Okay, I'm gonna keep this just in case. Well, let's try something. That worked.
Lumos.
God dang it.
Sendo.
There.
Lumos. You're not going to believe this. I can see the Undercroft.
What? A daydream?
No.
Because that happens to me too.
It's not. I think that might also be
I know it sounds strange.
Honestly,
but
nothing you say sounds strange to me anymore.
Fair enough.
Jeez.
I can see the Undercroft through this stone wall, as though it's a window. This has happened before.
I'm listening.
I think it's to do with my ability to see traces of ancient magic.
But you said you didn't really understand it, and that you couldn't wield it.
That's true, but I'm still not sure what it all means.
Wait, I'm saying that I can't wield it yet.
My ability allows me to travel.
I can fucking kill people with it.
Wait, we can get straight to the Undercroft from here. Ominous will be flawed.
We can, but perhaps best not to tell anyone else about this for now. Even Ominous.
Understood. Well then, invisible, secret, ancient magic passageway. Here we come.
Yeah,
I'm tempted to hold my breath.
So, give me 1 second. There we go. So, let's do this. See where, well, the Undercroft is, where? I don't remember. Also, he just seems to be going along with everything we do.
Why would the door lead us here?
Wants us to do something,
Sebastian,
maybe.
Look.
Why did I see it before, though? Maybe I needed to get through there to activate that. Well, that's helpful. Oh, is that a piece of the map?
Why hide a triptych here? Revelio.
Seems as if something's missing.
A note. Let's have a look.
Can I turn it? Nope.
Anything helpful in the notes?
Rune diagram. Not really.
A rune symbol. I've seen similar symbols used by the keepers.
I've been thinking. A keeper lived in that house centuries ago, and Ranrok and his lot have been searching there. You said that goblins may be wielding some form of this ancient magic. Do you think Anne was cursed by ancient magic?
Yep.
I can't be sure, of course, but I don't think so. I didn't see any traces of it around your sister.
Hmm. Very well. But that doesn't mean it's not ancient magic. There's still so much we don't know about it.
True. Perhaps this triptych will lead us to answers.
Then we'll have to unravel what this all means.
Yep.
But now I need to see Ominous. Don't worry. I won't tell him anything.
Okay.
Did I mention that, apparently, Salazar Slytherin had a secret scriptorium here, in Hogwarts?
You did not. Sounds worth looking into. Any idea where in the castle?
No idea. Ominous just learned of it. I'll let you know what I find out.
Okay.
I had no idea our visit to Cian would unfold into all of this. My head's an utter mess. But I'm glad you told me everything you did.
Yep. You're welcome, Hope.
I'll be in touch. Till then.
Okay. So then... And here I can practice...
Leviosa, Sender, Coulter, Confringo.
There we go. So I just do this.
Nice.
So we're probably gonna have to talk to Professor Figgs or whatever.
Meet me near the ruins of Falbutton Castle. After dark, do not tell anyone.
I won't. So what is this? Astronomy class. Let's just go to astronomy class for now. We've been going to too many adventures for now, so let's just go have fun in class. We also haven't done an astronomy class, right? Well, we'll find out. Hey! Well, I haven't seen him in a while. I guess because I also fast travel everywhere. Nope, that's not what I want. So we're still needing to go up. Hello, sir. Was that Sir Nicholas? There we go. Damn. Class at night? I don't know if that's cool or not.
And your reading is The Dragon. That's exciting, I suppose.
Damn.
Perhaps you're due for an adventure.
I thought she was going to say, perhaps you're due for your period. Hi.
Ladies.
Professor Shah.
Astronomy is not divination. You won't find the mysteries of the cosmos jotted out on your palms or at the bottom of your teacups.
Huh?
Alas, the heavens remain hazy to the starry-eyed. Now, if you were to devote yourselves to persistent and painstaking observation, you just might catch a glimpse. With that in mind, please take your telescopes. Tonight we will be on the observation deck.
Okay. Ooh! Oh, are we gonna get to some...
Still don't have your own? You can't be the new student forever, you know. You can share with Mr. Takar.
Here, I can adjust that for
no,
you.
No, bring it into focus on your own.
Damn. Stimp. No. Damn, I'm using my glasses. Whoa, this is actually really cool. They weren't so blurry.
Now, I expect all of you to put in your stargazing hours outside of class. Is that clear?
But, Professor, it's freezing out.
Mere cold didn't stop the great stargazers of the past. Look only to the astronomy tables they erected throughout the highlands from which they gazed millennia ago on the very selfsame stars above us. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Dismissed.
I have a coat on. Why would I? I also have a scarf. Why am I cold?
Hello. I don't believe we've met officially. I'm Amit. I'm something of an astronomy buff.
Hello, Amit. It's nice to meet you.
Did I hear Professor Shaw say that you don't have your own telescope?
I don't.
I have a spare one you could borrow for the rest of term.
Thank you,
that's
how kind.
Very kind of you, Amit. Are you sure you won't need it?
I'm certain. It's my old one. I finally got my hands on the
what
new
should be
Celestia
better than his?
Templar. You've heard of it, I assume?
No.
I mean, of course you have. It's only the pinnacle of all
personal
stargazing implements.
Option of like
but
saying
my
no.
old model's not too shabby either. Goblin cut glass, first rate optical enchantments. Hate to think such a fine instrument is just collecting dust.
Well, I thank you, Amit.
Think nothing of it. Anyway, the telescope's in the storage room right underneath us. You can't miss it.
Okay.
I have some reading to finish on the lower deck. Come find me there afterwards and bring the telescope. There's something I want to talk to you about.
Okay. Are we up to getting into trouble now? Is this? No, it wasn't there. So I gotta go down there. Oh, it's through here.
It's a dog, isn't it?
What is this? Sorry. Wait, what is this? Oh! Nice! I didn't think that was actually gonna work.
This was his old telescope. Looks practically brand new.
Well, he probably Rebellion. Took care of it.
A pristine night for stargazing.
Professor Shaw is just about as cold
hey, Wesley.
And distant as the bloody stars she wants us to chart. Not how I want to just spend
Here.
My evening.
Our meat thinks he knows everything.
Nice.
He can speak gobbledygook. Sounded like
Yeah, whatever, kiddo.
The perfect night for
I have the telescope. It's nicer than
So what happens if there's class and it's
would not
cloudy?
Offer a prospective stargazer a third-rate lunoscope. But there is something else.
What?
Yes. What is it?
You remember those astronomy tables Shaw was going on about? It just so happens I've been reading up on them a little myself.
Okay.
And it seems there may be one right here at Hogwarts. I believe we could use it to find hidden constellations.
A dragon or... So the telescope came with a catch?
And you need someone to help you find it.
I do. Are you in?
Sure.
No one from the Gobstones Club will go with me. Said they'd rather get spit at by a stone than... Well... They are cowards. Let us get moving while the stars are still out. I'll show you how to use that telescope once we get there. I promise.
Okay.
No need to convince me. Let's get going.
Brilliant. You won't regret it. Shall we?
You need to be moving it, sir. Oh, we're out here. Okay.
The table is on a castle wall ahead. Look for a stone platform, something that doesn't quite belong. We'll know it when we
Can't
see
fly.
It.
Cool.
Onwards we go then. Some say the locations of the tables were originally marked by centaurs for ritual stargazing.
What is this?
Revelio.
It is nice having a fellow yes. stargazer to explore with.
Yeah.
Happy to be here. It is good to leave the classroom now and then.
It's not that creepy out here at night, is it?
I didn't
the
say that.
The Gobstones Club are cowards.
So what is this?
Here I am, charging ahead.
If you're sure. Boarding. A few cobwebs and some dust. Nothing to be concerned about.
Hmm.
Oh, of course. It's just not as... tidy, as I
expected.
We're gonna do this. So if there's any fucking thing around the... Wait, did I miss something from back there? Nope. Wait, is that a body? It is. Okay. Hope he's having fun. Or she, I don't know.
More cobwebs. You don't think any spiders might be
lurking
about?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Not this close to the school, Amit.
So...
The constellation should appear near the center of your view.
Can I zoom in? Oh, this is actually really cool.
As soon there. As you've lined up the telescope,
that's really
we will
cool.
be able to fill out our star chart. I was right about the tables. They really are gateways to the far stars, just as the book said. And your contribution was invaluable. Rest assured, you shall be credited in my memoirs one day.
Thank you.
Thank you, Emmett. I look forward to reading them.
And I look forward to writing them.
This is only the beginning. You will find more tables like this one throughout the grounds and forest, all beckoning to be discovered by a worthy astronomer.
And if I have ever seen one, it's you. Oh, and about my old telescope. Don't bother returning it. You should keep it.
That's quite generous. Thank you.
You are welcome. It has goblin-cut glass and a gobbledygook inscription. I'm practically fluent in gobbledygook, you know. It's all in the throat, really, gobbledygook, you know, and how you pronounce your R's. Anyway, glad our adventure was a success. I will see you soon.
Okay. Bye-bye.
What an excellent room.
Thank you. Damn, he's really a simp. Anyway. Ooh, can I do some of this? So yeah, we were able to do like these trials every now and then. I haven't done one in a while. Are we about to face off? Oh, we'll do this and then we'll call it an episode.
Are you here for Summoner's Court?
I am. I'm actually rather good at it. Used to play all the time with my brother until... never mind. Well, shall we begin?
She probably yes, beat her ass, or he
then
beat
let's
her.
Get summoning.
Okay. Okay, court rules. Oh, nope, it's not what I want. Okay.
Yes!
That was good. But let me teach you how to do it. I'm gonna try to do this. Fuck yeah, I got me on 50. Well, I gave her 52.
That was sensational.
I gotta knock her down though. Huh. Ah, shit. Oh, there's like portals and shit. Okay. Whee! Okay. Damn, girl, you're bottom. Oh, well, I won.
What was I thinking?
So I just gotta... There. There. Oh, my God, I couldn't have done it better.
How am I to top that? That
I don't
settles
know.
It, then.
Damn, she was real salty. I forgot my name was Dino Nuggies.
After your poor show against Natty in class, I thought I could beat you. Appears I overestimated
my poor show?
Don't say that, Samantha. You're a fine player.
Well, that's very kind of you. Let's just say if I'm good, then you're better. I happen to know who you're up against next, and she's no shy opponent. Best of luck.
Okay. Thank you. I'm gonna go to the room of requirements or whatever the fuck. Yeah. And look at the legendary thing we got. There we go. So we got this. Ooh! Increased spell damage while concealing. Oh. Not very good, but sure. Alrighty. Can we change it? I can. Okay, so we have that. Ancient magic, chomping explosive, grilling crazy mandrake. I can't really do that one yet. Okay. We're going to call it an episode here. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please do like if you like the video. Comment down if you have any tips on this game. And thank you for watching. Bye-bye.